طيب يونت 3 بيتكلم عن we will talk about more Verilog HDL programming details. In unit 1 we went through يعني the very basic operators and we saw how to implement a simple combinational circuit using the operators اللي هي AND, OR and invert using the assigned statement. We saw how to create a module, how to define the module, define the input, define the outputs, and any internal wires that can be used to simplify your design or to make يعني, your code more readable. طيب, objectives of this unit that we will present additional details on the use of concurrent statement in Verilog. We will review some Verilog HDL operators and variable types. I'm sure in the lab, يعني you have gone through, I think you are more advanced than the lectures in using Verilog. ولكن يعني we'll talk about them in more formal way. Also at the end of this unit, we'll give an example of modeling a multiplexer using different assignment techniques. طيب, بالنسبة للmultiple assignments, we can specify يعني many outputs in a single assigned statement separated using commas. فمثلا in this statement حنعتبر انه عندنا the following inputs. We have input x, y and cn, and then we have also two outputs. We have c out and s. طبعا this is an assigned statement for a full adder. So we can use only one assigned statement and we write C out as XY or XCN or YCN. And then we'll use a comma to start defining the other output. For these two are outputs, C out and S. So S is equal to X, X or Y, X or CN. We can also write if we take out this one, you can use another assigned statement for S. ولكن for multiple assignment, you can use comma to separate each output in a single line. طيب, for a multi-bit signal assignment, we have to use the bitwise operator. طبعا هذه الoperators اللي هنا, الAND والOR. We don't have an inverter, but the logical inverter is gonna be the exclamation mark. For multi-bit signal, that means if you have, for example, A0, A1, A2, and you wanna write it into one variable, you have to define that A is a 3-bit signal. For the way you define it, either an input or output, we're gonna use parentheses and the range of bits. فعندنا input 2 to 0 of AB, that means we have A2, A1, A0, and we have B2, B1, B0. Same for the output, 2 to 0, that means this is C2, C1, and C0. So in a signed statement, if they're all the same size, we have to use the bitwise operator to operate on multi-bit signals. You cannot use the logical operator اللي هي AND. AND تشتغل only on one bit against one bit. بالنسبة للbitwise operator, a single AND, that's gonna operate on the whole vector. فبالتالي C equal A and B will translate into A0 and B0 will be stored in C0. A1, B1 will be stored into C1. A2, B2 will be stored into C2. Same, you can write, I mean, a more, يعني, less favorable way to do it, but it will lead to the same result. إنك تيجي عند الانبوت, and you define it as input A2, A1, A0, B2, B1, B0. and then you're going to define out as C2, C1, C0, and use an assign statement as assign C0 equal to B0 and A0, comma, C1 equal to A1, B1, and C2 equal to A2, B2. Now, this code will lead the same result as the one up here. ولكن it's obvious that this one is much simpler. And it makes more sense, especially if you have, if you're operating on a vector of data, which يعني you usually do. مثلا in an adder, إذا بتستخدم 4-bit adder, it's easy to say A plus B instead of feeding each bit of A and each bit of B to full adder and reading out the sum and carry out. So again, for multi-bit signal, this is how we define them. We will use a vector from the most significant bit to the least significant bit. Let's say A is an 8-bit number. So we will define input 7 to 0, A. So this will create A, input A of 8-bit. If you want to take 1-bit of this vector, you write, مثلا نستخدم ال 5th bit, so we write A of 4. This is the 5th bit. And the first bit is A of 0. طيب, we have other definition, which is called parameter. البارامتر عبارة عن constant. It's equal, يعني في الجافا كان أعتقد if you want to define a constant, you have to go before your, before writing your method, إيش كانت؟ توقع final. You have to say public أو static variable. لا, public static final. مثلا integer x equal to 5. So anywhere in your code, you're gonna write x, that's gonna translate into 5. And then if in your code, you said x is equal to 2, مثلا بتغير the value of x, that's not gonna compile. It's gonna give you an error. لأنه public static final will create a constant. So if you wanna use a constant in Verilog, we'll use the word parameter. So let's say if you said parameter n is equal to 4, so anywhere in your code where you use n, that's gonna be 4. مثلا if you wanna assign a vector a, مثلا can 2-bit equal to n, that will make 2, this will make a is equal to 2, a is equal to 4, sorry. A is equal to 4. طبعا, this 4 is in decimal. There are ways that you can write, we're gonna go through them, you know, how to write the number in binary. So you can say that parameter S0 is equal to 00, parameter S1 equal to 01, parameter S2 equal to 10, and parameter S3 is equal to 11. So writing the code this way will make it more readable later on when you, let's say you're making a 4 to 16 multiplexer. Sorry, a 16 to 1 multiplexer. A 16 to 1 multiplexer, you're gonna need 4-bit for select line. 4-bit, so this is not a 16, لا, مش 16. هتكون في هذه الحالة, you have 2 bits of select, that means a 4 to 1 multiplexer, معلش. A 4 to 1 multiplexer will take 2-bit select input. So instead of writing in your code 00011011, you can define that I'm gonna select input 0 at S0, I'm gonna select input 1 at S1, I'll select input 2 at S2, and input 3 at S3. And you define the select in your parameter as shown. So a constant is just gonna be a substitution of your code. So it's exactly equal to in your code, مثلا خلينا نقول let's just use an assign. تمام assign x افترض x هي output equal to s1. So what the compiler is gonna do is gonna take off s1 and replace it with 01. It's just text replacement. ولكن defining parameters, it's gonna make your code more readable. طبعا if you use names that make sense, طبعا s0, s1, s2, and s3, these are names that make sense. We know that we use s for select mostly. Parameter n, يعني ما هي واضحة كفاية إلا لو بتكلم عن context معين, ولكن you can name it anything. طيب بالنسبة لل signal وال constant وال يعني الأرقام بصفة عامة أو ال value of the signals, any signal in Verilog اللي هي ال input, ال output, ال wire can have one of four possible values. يا إما logic zero, طبعا this is for a single bit. يا إما logic zero اللي هي zero one, this is the logic level logic value one and logic value zero. We already know that. We have two more, which is z and x. So z is the high impedance, which means it's not connected. This is just like the output of a tri-state buffer with input x, output y, and an enable signal. So if enable is equal to zero and you're gonna use y somewhere else, the value of y is gonna equal to z, which is high impedance, means this output is not connected. تمام so small z or high or capital z that both gonna be high impedance. Value x, that means this is an unknown value or I don't care. Unknown value, let's say for example you in your code you had an AND gate connected to an inverter. Out these two outputs are connected together and you have one at all inputs. So this is gonna be one, that's gonna be zero. So this is gonna be an unknown value. Oh, you can use it as a don't care if you wanna define don't cares in your system. طيب بالنسبة للvector, how can you write the value of the vector? There is a way or a format that you're gonna use. So first you're gonna say the size in bits of this number. Let's say four, that means I'm gonna write a 4-bit number. And then apostrophe, a tick sign. The radix, you're gonna define the base of the number. بالنسبة للbase مثلا, if you use binary, اللي هو base two, so you're gonna write four tick B. That means whatever comes after this line is gonna be taken as a 4-bit binary number. فإذا كتبت 4 tick B equal to 1011, that means this is S, so S will equal to 1011. طيب طبعا بالنسبة للradix, we have these allowable values, D for decimal, B for binary, H for hexadecimal, and O for octal. If we did not decide using details of how many bits and radix, it's gonna translate into a decimal. So A equal to four, that's gonna be 100. You can also write it as A equal to 4-bit or 3-bit. 3-bit 100. This will also be 100. So the default value is decimal, unless you specify a different radix. I'm gonna use decimal, binary, hexadecimal, or octal, whatever suits your system. Okay, let's take examples of these number in Verilogs. if you write zero, that's going to translate into the number zero. If you write 1 0 without any definition of the radix, that's going to translate into a decimal number 10. That's not 1 0 in binary. That's going to be 10 in decimal. إذا حددت the radix without the number of bits, so this will translate into the minimum number of bits to represent your number. فبالنسبة لي binary 1 0, that's gonna be 2 bits binary, which is 1 0, and it will equal to 2 in decimal. If you write hex 1 0, that means this is 16 in decimal. So as the number of bits, that's gonna be 5 bits. And 16 in decimal in binary is gonna be 10000. طيب تقدر تحدد the number of bits. فمثلا you want to write 4-bit 100. طبعا تلاحظ انه هنا this is 3-bit and you defined this value as 4-bit. So what it's gonna do, it's just gonna extend the number of bits to 4 by adding zeros to the left. So the value of this number is gonna be 0100. Four bit X, طبعا X هذه هي the value of the don't care. That's gonna translate into 4 bits of X. It's not gonna be X 0 0 0, because you cannot extend you can't extend the value of X because you don't know what's the value of X. طيب you can also write an 8-bit as follows. حددنا 8-bit وكتبنا الرقم اللي هو 1000001. في هنا underscore. The underscore في Verilog will be ignored when it's compiled. This is going to be the same as you saying 8-bit 1000001. So writing it this way or that way, it will translate to the same, exactly the same value. For underscore, you can put it for readability. افترض انت بتستخدم الرقم هذا in chunks of 4 bits. So it's easier for you to read the code that you have an underscore here. نفس فكرة البارامتر. كل البارامتر عبارة عن text replacement. ف instead of using the parameter, you can use the value directly. ولكن for code readability, it's better to use يعني to define the constant and give it, if you have a constant in your system, it's easier or it's more readable to give it a name, so it becomes obvious when you use it. طيب, the underscore is written for readability. That means this is equal to that. آخر شيء, we have an 8-bit hex number equal to fx. طبعا أهم شيء تلاحظ هنا إنه this has to be in bits. تمام. If you write 2 hex f مثلا, that's not gonna equal to 1111, او مثلا 1111000. هذه 2 مش معناته the number of digits of the system you're using. This is 2 bits. So if you have 2 digits in hex, this will translate into 8 bits. فبالتالي 8 tick h with the value of x, this will translate into f. So this is if, and this is the don't care. تمام. So it's important to note that this number is the number of bits and not the number of digits of whatever base or whatever radix you're using. طيب, بالنسبة للoperators, here يعني where it gets يعني a little bit confusing. عندنا I think this is about 9 categories of operators. أول category اللي هو ال bitwise operator. Bitwise operator, That means it will operate on the whole vector. طبعا, what are the bitwise operator? We have the nut, we have plus and minus, we have the and, or these two are XNOR. المفترض الإكسور okay, I think we're missing the XOR here. We also have A XOR B. هذه كلها bitwise operator. معناته it will operate on the whole vector. The result of any operation, it's going to be the length of A. If it's a one operand operator, the nut or plus or minus, you only have one operand, اللي هو A. The result will be the length of A. If A is 8-bit, the answer is 8-bit. If A is 4-bit, the answer is 4-bit. بالنسبة لي, any two operands operation for the bitwise operation, that's going to be the maximum length of LA or LB. يعني خلينا ناخذ مثال سريع. Let's do A is equal to 1101, B is equal to 0111, and you want to see the result of A and B. So this is a bitwise AND. That means C will equal to, you will take it one by one. That's why it's called bitwise. So this is going to be 1010. طيب, if A is equal to 11011 and B is equal to 101, you defined A as 5-bit and defined B as 3-bit. واستخدمت C is equal A and B. So the answer is going to be the maximum length of A and B. So the answer has to be in 4-bit, in 5-bit. That means B has to be extended into 5 bits. So it's going to be, we'll just insert zeros to the left. And then the result is going to be 10000. This is the value of C. تمام, for the bitwise operation will give you the length of the same operand, or the maximum if you have different lengths for two operands. طيب, هذه bitwise operator. Logical operator, we only have the NOT, the AND, and the OR. The result of the logical operator has to be 1-bit, which is going to be either true or false. يعني يا إما 1 يا إما 0. A has to be 1-bit if you want to use the logical NOT. The logical AND, it's also going to be used on 1-bit each. And then the logical OR, that's going to be the same. أعتبر أنه الانسر او الريزلت اوف لوجيكال اوبريشن اتس لايك وين يو ايفالويت ان اف ستيتمنت. ذا اف ستيتمنت وات ايفر يو بوت انسايد, اذا عندك اي اف ستيتمنت عندك هنا نمبر اوف كونديشنز في الاخير. ات ذا اند اوف ذا داي, وات ايفر كونديشنز اند فاليوز يو بوت ان هير, ذا انسر هاز تو بي ايذر ترو اور فولس. فذاتس واي اتس كولد لوجيكال. طيب, we have something called a reduction operator. A reduction, the result of the reduction is going to be 1-bit, ولكن the value of A can be any number of bits. Even in the logical operator, it can be any number of bits, ولكن the answer is going to be 1-bit. تمام, for this will, طبعا reduction, we will talk about each one in details. ولكن to write the reduction, it's going to be going to reduce it to AND, or reduce it to NAND, or NOR. These two are XNOR. I'm not sure whether this slide is not showing the XOR, because you can also write XOR A. طبعا الريدكشن اللي بيسوي انه اذا عندك نمبر A, let's say it's 1101 and you said AND A, what it's gonna do, it's gonna take A and split it into each bit of A is gonna be ANDed together. So this is A of 0 and A of 1 and A of 2 and A of 3. Same for the remaining operators. This is gonna NAND all the values. This will OR the values. This will NOR the values. This will XNOR it. These both will XNOR the value of A, and this should XOR the value of A. طيب, we also have relational. Relational, that means we're gonna compare two numbers into a certain way. Are they equal? So if A is equal to B, that means if A is equal to B, let the value of this operation be 1. If A is not equal to B, make it 0. Same for A is not equal to B, greater than, less than, greater than or equal, less than or equal. بعدين عندنا another equal sign, ولكن it's triple equal instead of 2. طبعا اول شيء remember انه a single equal, this is an assignment. Double equal, this is a comparison. Triple equal is also a comparison. These two are comparisons. ولكن الفرق في triple equal او not and then double equal, الفرق انه this can takes into account the value of don't care and the value of high impedance. This will not work with don't cares and high impedance. Well, I can triple equal will take don't care and high impedance into account. طبعا, the result of any relational operator is gonna be 1 bit, also true or false. This is true or false. And reduction, not reduction, logical will also be a true or false value. طيب, arithmetic, we have the four basic arithmetic operators that we know: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Also, we have the modulo, which is the remainder of the result of any of this division. So this is gonna take A divided by B, and it will give you the remainder of this operation. Same as we did for the bitwise, the result of this operation is gonna be the maximum of the length of A and the length of B. If they are not the same size, the smaller one will be extended into the larger one, and then it will operate on, to do the operation, and the result is gonna be the maximum length of A or B. Depends. طيب, بعد كده عندنا shift. You can either shift right or shift left by a certain amount. For example, this one, A shift left by B, this is how you read it. A shift left by B. That means A will be shifted by the amount of B. على سبيل المثال, خلينا A equal to 1101, and you said A shift left by 2. The value of B مثلا كانت 2 هنا. The result of A, the new result of A, let's store it into C. So C will equal to 0100. This shift right and shift left will add zeros into the value shifted. If you write A shift right by 2, it's gonna be make C is equal to 0011. طبعا, أنا بعتبر A is this value here, اللي هي 1101. طيب, and then we have concatenate. This is just the same as you did in also in Java, you were able to concatenate strings mostly. إذا كان عندك string x equal to AB مثلا, you have a string y equal to C, and then you print, or you make a new string مثلا string z equal to x plus y. طبعا in Java when you operate on strings the plus sign is not is this allowed in Java? I don't remember. So x plus y, if this is concatenation, this will make z is equal to abc. وصراحة ما أتذكر إذا this works in Java, ولكن it works in Python. In Python, when you add two strings using the plus operator, it's gonna concatenate these two values. In Java, ماني فاكر صراحة. I think it's the same. If you operate plus on a string, it should concatenate the string. طيب, for the length of concatenation, it's gonna be open. So if you concatenate, let's say A and B, if A is 3-bit, B is 5-bit, that means the result is gonna be 8-bit. Concatenation, you'll just put the numbers next to each other. فمثلا, أخذ مثال سريع. Let A be equal to 10, B is equal to 1101. And then you use this operation, which is you wrote AB. تمام? You wrote C is equal to AB. So C will equal to 10, 1101. تمام? This is the result. Concatenation, you just put things next to each other. فبالتالي size of A is 2, size of B is 4. That means the size of C is going to be 6. That's why here we define the size as length of A plus whatever you have in between plus the length of B. You can also replicate. This is also like multiplying strings by each other in Python, which it will repeat by the number you multiply by. If you write B of A, let's change, let's take an example. So let's say A is equal to 101, B is equal to 10. And I wrote C, B of A. The result of this operation is gonna make C is equal to A مكررة B times. فيو write 101 101, because the value of B is equal to غلط غلطة هنا انه I should write this as 3-bit, this is 2-bit of 10. So the answer is going to be 101 101. بالتالي the length of the output is going to equal to the length of A multiplied by the value of B. That's why the length output will be B multiplied by L of A. طيب آخر شيء عندنا الكونديشن. Condition, we write it this way: A question mark B, C. So the length of C, the length of the result. The result مش مكتوب هنا. فمثلا إذا كتبنا F is equal to A, B, C. The value of F will equal to B if A is true, or if A is 1. And F will equal to C if A is false or 0. تمام? فF can equal to B or can equal to C depending on the value of A. Meaning F can have different sizes. يا إما the length of B or the length of C. معلش لا بتكون الماكسيمم of these two values. A quick example would be that A حتكون الكونديشن. فلتس سي B is equal to 3-bit 101 and C equal to 4-bit 0011. And you write F is equal to A question mark BC. So if will has to be the maximum of these two. It cannot be the minimum. لأنه if يعني رسيت على C, بالتالي it has to store 4 bit. ف the size of if will directly take the maximum of these two, which is gonna be 4 bit. تمام. ف this is a summary of all the Verilog operators that you have. يعني we went through them. ولكن all of them is gonna be detailed in the next few slides. طيب ف the details gonna be as follows. طبعا of course we have a large number of operators. We يعني there are 9 categories of operation and the number of operators is much higher than that. بالنسبة للكولوم الأخير اللي كنا بنتكلم عنه, this will give you the number of bits for the result of this operation. تمام. And it's important to understand it. طيب, in the first column كان عندنا اللي هي bitwise operation. We had كان عندنا negative A and positive A. هذه اللي يمكن الاثنين اللي شوية غريبة. Negative A will give you the 2's complement of A. So this is a mathematical negative. It will give you the 2's complement of A. لأنه not A will just invert the bits in A. If A is equal to 101, not A will equal to 010. تمام؟ Which is the 1's complement of A. ولكن if A is equal to 101 and you want to calculate or you used negative A, that's gonna be 110, which is the 2's complement of A. Also note that the XNOR can be written either not XOR or XOR not, both is gonna mean an XNOR operation. طيب, النقطة الأخيرة اللي ذكرناها إنه التريبل إيكوال can be used if when comparing variables containing don't cares and high impedance. So this is the modulo operation. We also talked about that. طيب, this is also more details about each operation in Verilog. This will give you the number of operands in each of these operations. So bitwise can have either one or two operands. A NOT will take only one variable. بالنسبة للbitwise AND, bitwise OR, XOR and XNOR, obviously it needs two operands. يعني إما AB, A or B, A or XOR B, and so on. طيب, as we mentioned, this table will give you more details about each operation and how many operands you're gonna need for performing that operation. All of them is gonna be either one or two operands, except the concatenation. So concatenation can be any number, لأنه you can add يعني as many variables as you want. Replication is also gonna have an any number of operand. You can also add لأنه inside we can write مثلا B A C مثلا 2 bit 01 and so on, and then multiply it by B. So this is also gonna be any number of operands. بالنسبة للcondition, that's gonna have three operands. One is four. And then if we write C is equal to A conditioned on B and C. So you're gonna have the two values that's gonna be stored into C depending on A. So this is a three operand operation. All the remainder is gonna be either two or one. يعني as you know it. طيب so far في أي سؤال before we move on؟ اوكي طيب طيب as we mentioned the bitwise operand will operate in two operands. And it's going to take each bit and perform whatever operation you're doing on يعني on the second operand. ف if we have input A is a 4 bit, we have input A B each is 4 bit, we have 5 outputs also will be 4 bit each, and then you assign, you can use the assignment statement to assign A and B, A or B, A X or B. This is not A and B, which is the NAND, and this is not A or B, which is an OR. For Y1 will be, how many bits we have? That's gonna be, so Y1 is also 4 bit, فبالتالي you will create 4 AND gates بالنسبة لأول operation. So this is going to be Y1 of 0. This will be Y2. لا. Y1 of 1. And then Y1 of 2. And then Y1 of 3. بالنسبة للإنبوت, that's going to be A of 0. B of 0, A of 1, B of 1, and so on. So this is the bitwise operation. Same for the others, for the other operators. طيب, something that is important, اللي هو precedence. Precedence اللي هو التفضيل بين operations. زي لما كنت تكتب مثلا F is equal to A and B or C, تمام, we know that the AND has a higher precedence than the OR. For this is, this will be exactly as if A and B or C, تمام. So it's not gonna be B or C and then take the AND with A. فطبعا because we have so many operands or so many operators في ال مو operands, so many operators in in Verilog, it's important يعني to see how these precedence will work. ف this table will summarize the precedence we have. That's gonna be the highest up to the lowest. For the highest is going to be the complement and reduction operator. Don't confuse this AND and NAND or XOR or XNOR with the AND, NAND, and XOR, XOR, XNOR here. تمام؟ هذه bitwise. I mean, they look the same, ولكن when you write them, it's different. For complement or reduction, it's going to have higher precedence, the highest precedence. And then we have multiplication, division, or modulo. And then add, subtract. طبعاً هذه just the same as mathematics. بعد يجيك a logical shift. And then this was not mentioned in the previous table, ولكن if you want to shift left or right arithmetically, that's going to use three signs instead of two. But this is shift right, which will shift in zeros. This will be shift arithmetic right, which should extend the sign bit instead of the zero. طيب بعد كده جينا الكومباريزن. So the greater than and less than, greater than or less than have higher precedence than the equal and not equal. فإذا كان عندنا A greater than or equal to B equal equal to C مثلا. So this should take لخبطنا يعني if you have a line this way you should first get the value of A greater than or B and then you're gonna equate it to C أو compare it to C. بعدها عندنا الاند والناند. الاند والناند have higher priority than the XOR XNOR and the XOR XNOR have higher priority than the OR NOR. بعدها يجيك اللوجيكال اوبريتر و lastly will be يعني the lowest it's gonna be ال conditional statement. طيب بالنسبة لللوجيكال شيفت والاريثمتيك شيفت، اللوجيكال شيفت سواء رايت اور ليفت يو ويل اكستند زيروز as we mentioned. فاذا كان عندك 0001 0111 and you want to shift right by 1 bit, shifting right by 1 bit معناته you read this number and then you will add 0 to the left. This is shifting right by 1 bit. For the same number, if you want to shift left one bit, فبالتالي you will add zero from here, and then you read the number from here. طيب, الarithmetic, if you remember, الarithmetic, it will extend the sign bit when you shift right. A shift left arithmetic should equal to the shift left logical. I think if you shift left logically, you have to extend zero unless let's read a left arithmetic shift of a binary number by one. The empty position in the last significant bit is filled with zero. So this is exactly, yeah. So if you look at the picture, that's going to be exactly the same. So a shift left in arithmetic or in logical, the results are going to be the same. حيفرق معاك الarithmetic shift right. الarithmetic shift right, instead of adding zero, you will add the sign bit. If this number is zero, you will add or you will extend with zeros. If this sign is one, you will extend with one. Let's take a quick example. إذا كان عندي 1100, تمام؟ If this is A, وأبغى A shift right by one, this will give me 0110. If you want to shift right A by arithmetic or arithmetic shift by one of A, طبعا A هنا, that's gonna be 1110. Instead of adding zero, we added the sign bit. إذا أساسا السين بت كان zero مثلا 0011 ونبغى arithmetic shift right by one. هنا A will equal to 0001. تمام؟ The only difference between logical shift and arithmetic shift is going to be in the right direction where we extend the sign bit instead of extending zeros. تمام؟ وال shift left is just going to be the same. Yeah, so in this description say that note that the operation is the same as that for the left logical shift. And this is the explanation for the sign extension. Later we'll talk about بالنسبة للشيفتنج يعني it has many uses ولكن one of them is يعني give you the value of multiplication or division by power of twos. We'll see it inshallah next class. Next class, Tuesday's class inshallah. طيب في أي سؤال؟